we know that the father of the lie is heavily at work in the legal world. Of course, the legal states have documents that get filled in with asking or basically requiring truth mixed in with an error or a lie, a fiction. So it's interesting that the father of the lie would lead to the legal title that he wants you to bear. So you'd be bearing the burden of debt under that title as part of a legal citizenship of men. The book of Proverbs, pro and verb, for action. It's how to walk. Read the book of Proverbs, especially chapter 1, will tell you everything you could possibly ever need to know about what is going on right now. But we're here dealing with Proverbs 18, and it clearly speaks in verse 5. It says, "It is not good to accept the person of the wicked, to overthrow the righteous in judgment." Once you've accepted and walked by that legal title, you've walked into judgment and you've allowed them to take you out of truth and bring you into the bondage of the legal. So this is truly legal bondage due to not knowing the error of our ways, and because everybody's doing it, everybody says we need to do this. False Christianity speaks about being subject to the higher powers in a manner that is not meant in the book of Romans. Unfortunately, misunderstood. We'll deal with that on another seminar. But in this moment here, we're just dealing with the truth out of the Bible. What does the Bible say in John chapter 8, verse 32? "And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free." Other versions say set you free. So it appears that there would be an escape out of something. Paul spoke many times of being freed from the burden of the legal world or the law of men, being at liberty from that, not at liberty from God in truth, but at liberty from the falsehood that Satan has created under sin. So we also read in verse 44, he spoke about the devil and his enterprises and those that would follow him. Especially Jesus was speaking to the Pharisees and to those that were following the lie of Satan. And he says, "Ye are of your father the devil, and the lusts of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it." So he is the father of these legal fiction lies and titles of the wicked. And therefore, when we look at the word truth, even in the law, it'll state that there are three conceptions as to what constitutes truth. Number one, agreement of thought and reality. We've already discussed in previous videos, when you define the word surname, even in a Canadian gauge dictionary found in the schools, it'll say a name added to one's real name. So we know that truth could only be in the reality of someone's original name or their given name, a fact name, not something that's part of the fictitious world of legal. Then it says number two, eventual verification. Well, of course, you would verify that. You would speak that. "Verily, verily, truly, truly, I say to you," are words that Jesus used in Scripture. And number three, any consistency of thought with itself. So if you're not thinking properly in your temple with truth, and you're mixing truth with the error, you're not walking in the truth that will set you free. You can't charge truth, but you can certainly charge for error. And because you walk in error, you'll be charged for your errors.